Hello, you're watching Proactive London. I'm joined by Dr. Daniel Vitt, President and CEO of Immunic. Daniel, very good to see you again.
Yeah, thank you. Good morning, Stephen.
Good morning. So Proactive last spoke to you early in January with news of your $240 million financing. That was clearly a vote of confidence in the company, important step. Tell us how you're planning to spend that money as the year progresses.
No, I think here at Immunic, I think we're all focusing on our successful program in multiple sclerosis. And the whole financing was driven by positive data we got in last October from our phase two clinical study, interim data from the progressive MS phase two CALLIPER study, where we had interim NFL data read out at that time point. And this is a good signal for success of the trial, and the full data from that study is expected in April 25. So the money is mainly used for this and also for continuing our phase three study in relapsing forms of multiple sclerosis in our two phase three studies, the ENSURE1 and ENSURE2 studies.
So, of course, this is all advancing work with vidofludimus calcium, is that right?
That's correct. And I think one thing here is super important, and it's something I need to always point to, is that vidofludimus calcium has shown signs of neuroprotection in the recent studies. And that makes vidofludimus calcium very different from other approaches in the whole space of multiple sclerosis. And I think this was one of the driving forces for investors to build that consortium and to more or less finance us in that way.
So Daniel, you said that the next big milestone is the readout of the CALLIPER trial, which you expect in April. Do you see this as a big catalyst for the company?
Oh, that's maybe a super catalyst, because I think if you look, and I think to understand the importance of that and of that data set, it is good to have a look on the competitive landscape, on the current treatment landscape, basically. And if you look on the whole field of progressive MS, there's more or less nothing. We have two principal forms of progressive multiple sclerosis. One is primary progressive, and the second one is secondary progressive MS. And for primary progressive, there's one treatment used and approved, which is Ocrevus from Roche. Whereas for secondary progressive, there's nothing available right now. So this is obviously a very underserved area with a lot of patients there with a lifelong disease. So that is, of course, super important from a medical point of view. And also, if I look on the from the pharma company point of view, this is a major market. This is not something small. We have a lot of patients affected by progressive MS. And in the absence of other treatments, of course, it could be a very attractive therapy for patients, but also for pharma companies to add that to their portfolio of drugs, which are currently used for relapsing MS in particular.
So tell us more about the ongoing programs and why your drug can stand out.
Yeah, that brings me back to this neuroprotective potential. So initially, we developed the drug starting with relapsing MS because the molecule was developed as a potent, safe inhibitor of so-called DHODH protein. What we found out, and we also published last year in an important publication in Journal of Medicinal Chemistry, was that vidofludimus calcium is an activator of NOR1 protein. NOR1 is a nuclear receptor which was proven already to be involved in neuroprotection. So what we found is that vidofludimus can upregulate neuroprotective signals, which could prevent neurons in the brain from death, and therefore it could have a long-lasting effect of neuroprotection in such patients. And we believe this makes it unique, this makes it different from everything else in that market. Coming back to the first initial mode of action, DHODH, that's also good, that's also supportive. So this drug has basically two tricks combined, which are exactly matching the medical need for the whole world of MS treatments.
Okay, so the readouts of the CALLIPER trial in April, a big milestone for the company. Which other milestones should investors be looking out for as the year progresses, Daniel?
Yeah, I think there's more as there's a futility analysis in our phase 3 RMS program planned for the second half of this year. We will not get any data. We will just get a decision from the monitoring board whether to continue or not to study or to make some sample size adjustments there. Other potential news flow could come from our second program, IMU-856. Usually, we don't have enough time to always talk about the second one as well, but it's an interesting new approach. It's a molecule which is aiming to restore a healthy gut environment by boosting the natural physiological function of gut renewal there, the epithelial layer in the gut. And we have proven last year in the clinical study and as part of the phase 1 study in the phase 1b that the drug has a positive impact in patients suffering from celiac disease. And we plan to expand that development. We are preparing a phase 2 study, but we're also in discussions with potential partners for this interesting program. And one of the reasons why this could be of specific interest to partners is that it can be applied very broadly, just beyond celiac disease only, also for other indications with high unmet medical need, among those short bowel syndrome or inflammatory bowel disease like Crohn's and colitis.
Well, Daniel, it sounds like you have a very significant year ahead for the company. I hope you'll keep us posted on any progress as you make it.
Yeah, thank you so much. I think really it's an interesting time for the team here and for the company.
I look forward to speaking to you again, Dr. Daniel Vitt, President and CEO of Immunic.